condition to apply the independence ambiguity test, we needed two group, we needed two independent variable IV, then we need a dependent variable. So the two variables are needed. Yes, now we have to tell the please kindly tell the independent variable types. So here you are getting the two scores, male achievement score, female achievement score. Anyone can tell which is an independent variable? What is the independent variable in this case? Normally, what is the hypothesis? There is no significant difference between male and female in their achievement scores, right? Or any scores, there is no significant difference between the male and female of the scores. Kindly tell in the group, there is a score, set of score, male group and female group. Here in this case, gender is the independent variable. The score is the dependent variable, right? So because based on the male and female only, the scores may difference. That is called this causing variable, this is an effect variable, okay? Gender is a causing variable, then dependent variable is the effect variable. Now, the next things, the gender, the independent variable should be a, please kindly tell at least this answer. The independent variable, what kind of data sets is needed? Whether it's a categorical nature or continuous, the data sets is called categorical. So the basis assumption to do a independent sampling test, independent variable should be categorical. What about the dependent variable? What about the dependent variable? So what is the dependent variable? Scores, the achievement scores. The dependent variable, what is the format? Is the group only the male and female is a group, but the scores, see the scores? The scores are, yeah, exactly, it's a continuous. Exactly, it's continuous, yes. So this is a basic assumptions we have to check for before attempting a t-test. So for doing a t-test, we need a two variable, independent variable, gender, categorical variable, and the gender, how many divisions only? Suppose if you have the male, female, transgender, can we do a t-test? Can we do a t-test? If the gender having the three category, like male, female, transgender, can we do a t-test? Please kindly type in the chat box. If the independent variable three category is there, can we adopt a t-test, independent sum t-test? Never. In the case of t-test, the categorical variable, by the categorical variable, only two category. Yeah. So only two category, like male, female, rural, urban, okay, Hindu, non-Hindus. Yes, that's correct. So this is the basic things, don't forget. Now, can we do a t-test now? Yes. Now, what is the path? What is the path? Data analysis. Kindly check what statistics may adopt. How many t-tests are there? How many t-tests are there? So in this, how many t-tests? Three t-tests are there. The first t-test in this data analysis one is called per two sample means. What it means, can we do this one for this case? Per sample means we have only one sample and two tests, like a pre-test, post-test, or two interview, you can do two tests for a single group, you can go with per sample. But this is called independent sample t-test. So you cannot be doing a per sample t-test in this case. Therefore, you can go with the equal variance of the two sample or two sample as an unequal variance. You can adopt anyone. What is the equal variance in the sense that normally in the case of the SPSS, we are checking the normality, checking and things in the equal variances assumed or even not assumed through SPSS. But here it's not possible, but we can assume like this. Suppose the both the group variance, I feel that the male and female variance are same. The variance are same. If I assume in the sense, I can go with equal variance assume. Suppose I feel that unequal, there is no chance but that both the groups, the variance should be same. Like that, if I assume in the sense, I can go for the unequal variance. But now, if you go with both, answer may be same only. I'm going with equal variance assumed. I'm clicking OK. Once you're clicking OK, it asks the variable one. What is my variable one? Is nothing but the male group. What is my variable two? My female group. So I'm giving the input male and female. Male variable one is a male. Variable two is a female. I'm clicking the labels also. The alpha value is nothing but level of significance. I'm clicking the output range. So I like to generate the output here. So I'm selecting the output ring J21. Then click OK. I'm getting the answer. See here. So very simple. I'm getting the t-test scores, the mean scores. This is the mean scores of male and female. The mean scores of male and female. Male is 47, female is 62. Therefore, in this case, the females are good. The variance is nothing but standard deviation square. Male 238, 320. The observation nothing but the number of male, number of female. Number of male 50, number of female 20. Then pooled variance in the case is not needed. Okay, only for the other things. Pooled variance is nothing but instead of a two variance, see here, we have the two variants of the male and female. But here the pooled variance, it's like the two groups together, it may come under the pooled variance. It's not needed normally in the case, but the output may come. Therefore, no need to check. Is default is taking the hypo the mean difference, because we are keeping that equal variance is no. And there is no equal, and therefore thick is zero and default. If you fix also no problem, but it won't be much impact on any data sets. Okay. So no need to be look on this one. Only you have to look on the T value. The T value is 2.56. Then the P value, in this case, if you are taking as a null hypothesis, you can go with the two-tail test. If you are making a null hypothesis, you can check the two-tail test. If you are making the direction hypothesis, you can look onto the one-tail test. But normally we are going with it to we are going with the null hypothesis only. So in the case of null hypothesis, I'm going with the two-tail. The p-value is 0.00. So now the people are now writing the interpretation based on the p-value only. 0.00. The p-value is 0.00. So 0.01. Okay. 01 is less than the level of significance of 0.05. It's less than 0.05. Therefore, it means the significant. Significant. Significant means the null hypothesis. Null hypothesis to be not predicted. So null hypothesis rejected. Null hypothesis rejected. So this is where we can come for conclusions about the hypothesis. So in this case, what it means in the sense, and there is a significant difference between male and female in the achievement scores. If you look on deeply about the mean score from the female mean scores are 62.5 and male scores are 46.66. From this, we may come for the conclusion that male groups are better than the female groups. Sorry, female groups are better than the male groups in the case of the achievement scores. Like that, we may come for the conclusions about the t-test. So this is where we can do a t-test analysis. This I'm doing only the two sample assumed equal variance. The same thing I'm going with unequal variance also. So I'm going to data analysis. The same thing in previous I used the equal variance. I'm going with now unequal variance. The variable one view. I'm selecting the variable one is a male group. Then variable two is a female. Female. Then alpha 0.05 and output range. I'm selecting the output range down. So I'm keeping the cursor. I'm keeping the output range here and click OK. So the problem, already some data are available on things. So I will keep it here. Okay. So I'm keeping default is to some input range can is non-numeric data. So the problem, I'm not selecting the label. That is why this happened. Then click OK. Now the results is coming. The same results only. Now see here. If you go with this one, unequal variance, you are getting the DF value also. DF value also. So this is where we can come for conclusion. The same interpretation, the same scores only. The T score and P word, P scores and all. So this is where we can do independent sample t-test. I hope you don't have any doubts. The t-test.